We're going to start with a Samavriti breathing exercise. So as usual, feel welcome to sit onto pillows, bolsters, or blocks, or even into a chair. That's good as well. Samavritti is equal breathing. We inhale for a count of four, hold for a count of four, exhale for a count of four, and hold for a count of four. And then inhale, hold, exhale, hold, and so on. It doesn't have to be a count of four. If it is too much for you now, a count of four, then do less. If you want to do a bit more, then do a bit more. Before we do the breath, we're just going to give a few deep breaths just to get into our breathing. Some of you just rushed in into your mat. So let's just start by breathing in deeply. Letting out. Keep going. Letting out. And you can exhale through the nose or through the mouth, whatever feels good. And we're going to add the Samavriti. So inhale for a count of four or less. Hold the breath for the same count. Exhale for the same count. Hold. Inhale. Hold. Exhale. Hold. Inhale. Now do it on your own time. Follow your own counting. Finish the round you're in, and then just come back into a normal breathing. Slowly opening the eyes. Let's do some side bends. Rest the left hand down onto the floor. Inhale, reach up with your right arm. On the exhale, lean over towards the left hand side, letting go of the neck. Inhale, lengthen through the spine, open the chest. On the exhale, lean towards the left side, letting go of the neck. Stay there. I'm just going to check because I think some of you are unmuted. Some sound coming in. There we go. Mute. Mute all. Continue. Very good. Okay. Breathing in. Breathing out. Deep inhale. On the exhale, release the right hand. Reach out through the fingers. Deep inhale, lengthen the spine. Exhale, relax both shoulders away from the ears. Breathing in. Breathing out. Letting go of the neck. Deep inhale, breathe into the side of the neck. On the exhale, allow both shoulders to relax completely. Fill up. Exhale, slowly release the right hand and bring the left hand to the side of the face. Deep inhale. Exhale, slowly come back into the center, bringing your head to the center. Switch sides, right hand down. Inhale, reach up through the left arm. On the exhale, lean towards the right, letting go of the neck. On the inhale, lengthen through the spine. Exhale, allow the left shoulder and the right shoulder to relax completely. Breathing in. Breathing out, neck relaxed. Deep inhale, breathe into the rib cage. Open the left side of the body. On the exhale, allow yourself to lean towards the right side a little bit more. Breathe in. Breathe out. Fill up. Exhale, reach the left hand towards the left-hand side. Spread the fingers wide. Deep inhale, lengthen through the spine. Exhale out. Breathing in. Breathing out. Deep inhale. Exhale, right shoulder moves away from the ear and left shoulder as well. Inhale, breathe into the side of the neck. Full exhale out. Fill up. Exhale, release your left hand. Bring the right hand to the side of the face. Inhale, come up into the center. Use your hand to bring you up to the center. Good. Inhale, reach up with the arms. Exhale, fold forward. No need to reach too much forward if you're going to bring the shoulders to the ears, but allow just the chest to fall towards the floor. On the inhale, lengthen through the chest. On the exhale, folding, elbows reaching down towards the floor. Breathing in. Breathing out. Now press the knees down. Rather than using your hands, use your muscles to press the knees down. Good. Fill up. Empty the air out. Shoulders away from the ears. Lead with the chest bone. Breathing in. Breathing out. Deep inhale. On the exhale, press the sit bones down. Keep your sit bones down onto the floor. Allow your chest to lower a little bit more. Fill up. On the exhale, slowly start to walk yourself up. Sitting up. Transition into your child's pose. Sit onto your heels, extend the arms forward. Rest the forehead onto the mat. Breathing in. Breathing out. So press the hips onto the heels, opening into the lower back. Deep inhale. Full exhale out. Breathe in. Breathe out. And now here in this child's pose, we're going to do a thread the needle. So the right arm is going to go under the left. So you're going to have to lift the face off the floor and just bring the right arm towards the left side, bringing the right shoulder down to the floor and side of the face down to the floor. Deep inhale. On the exhale, press the hips down onto the heels, open the side of the body. So you should feel a stretch on the right side. Breathe in. Breathe out. You can reach the right hand towards the side even more, opening more into the side of the body. Inhale. Full exhale. Breathe in. On the exhale, slowly come back into the center. Extend that right arm forward and let's switch arms. So now the left arm goes all the way towards the left side. Walk the hand towards the left. And open the chest. Breathing in. On the exhale, relax the neck. Let go of the head. Rest the head onto the floor or onto a block. Inhale. On the exhale, press the hips down onto the heels. Feel the opening in the left side of the body. Deep inhale. Full exhale out. Breathe in. Breathe out. Inhale. Exhale, slowly come back into the center. Extend both arms forward, deep inhale. On the exhale, come into your tabletop position. Transition straight into your down dog. Walk the dog here so you know how it works. Do whatever feels good in your body. On the inhale, you do one move. On the exhale, you do another move. Move slowly with awareness. And now come into a neutral position. Deep inhale. Full exhale out. Breathe in. On the exhale, step or walk forward to the front of your mat. Come into ragdoll. Feet as wide as your mat. Lift up the toes. Keep your feet engaged. Grab the elbows. Sway from side to side. Stay with your ujjayi breath. At the same time, your sit bones reaching up towards the ceiling. This helps to open the back of the legs. If it is too much to have your legs straight, have a slight bend on the knees and just start with ease into the pose. Release the hands, bring the feet together. Inhale, halfway lift, lengthen through the spine. Forward fold, exhale. Inhale, rise all the way up, lifting up through the fingers. On the exhale, hands into your heart center, closing the eyes. Breathing in, breathing out. We're opening the practice with three ohms. Inhale. Open the eyes. Have an amazing practice, everyone. Inhale, reach up with the arms. Forward fold, exhale. Halfway lift, inhale. Exhale, step back into your high plank. Hold the high plank, so bring your shoulders in line with your wrists. Feet in line, heels in line with the toes. Breathe in. On the exhale, bring the knees down as if you are on a tabletop position. Deep inhale. On the exhale, bend the elbows towards the back of the room and bring the chest towards the floor, coming into your puppy pose. Looking forward, chin down, inhale. On the exhale, transition into your cobra. Inhale, lengthen, lifting the chest. Exhale, downward facing dog. Breathing in, breathing out. Deep inhale. Full exhale out. Inhale, press the floor away with your hands. Good. On the exhale, relax the shoulders. Relax the neck, especially the neck. Breathe in. Breathe out. Fill up. Empty the air out. Deep inhale. Exhale, step or walk forward. Come to the front of your mat. Halfway lift, inhale. Forward fold, exhale. Inhale, rise up. Active feet, lifting up the toes. Exhale, bow forward, slight bend into the knees, allowing your spine to lengthen. Inhale, halfway lift. Exhale, step back, high plank. Knees down, tabletop position. Breathe in. Exhale, puppy pose. So the elbows bend to the back. Chest comes to the floor. Your bum sticks up. Breathe in. Breathe out. Inhale, transition into your cobra. Lifting the chest up, staying with your elbows bent. On the exhale, transition into your down dog. Breathing in. Breathing out. Deep inhale. Full exhale out. Inhale, press the whole hand onto the mat. Exhale, roll shoulders away from the ears. Breathe in. Breathe out. Fill up. Empty the air out. Deep inhale. Exhale, step or walk forward to the front of your mat. Half a lift, inhale. Forward fold, exhale. Inhale, rise up. Sparking up the fingers. Exhale, bow forward. Half a lift, inhale. Exhale, step or walk back. High plank. Bringing the knees down. Puppy pose. Bend the elbows. Chest to the floor. Breathing in. Breathing out. Inhale, cobra, squeezing elbows in. On the exhale, downward facing dog. Breathe in, breathe out. Deep inhale. Exhale, press the floor away and reach up with the sit bones. Fill up. Exhale out. Deep inhale. Full exhale. Breathe in. Breathe out, reaching down through the heels, although the heels don't have to touch the floor. Inhale. Exhale, step or walk forward. Half a lift, inhale. Forward fold, exhale. Inhale, rise up. Exhale, bow forward. Half a lift, inhale. Exhale, step or walk back, high plank. Knees down for puppy pose. Breathe in. Exhale, bend the elbows, chest to the floor, looking forward. Breathing in. Breathing out. Inhale, cobra. Lift up through the chest. Exhale, downward facing dog. Breathe in, breathe out. Bring the feet together at the back of the mat. Inhale, reach up with the right leg. On the exhale, square off your hips so we're not bending the knee this time, not going into a three-legged dog with the knee bent. Keep your right leg straight, flex the toes, and keep that right leg active. Deep inhale. On the exhale, hug your right hip into the left hip. So it's a squaring of the hips. And you start to feel a stretch all the way from the left calf muscle, back of the knee into the hamstring. Breathing in, breathing out. This means that the right leg probably doesn't go so high like usually, but we're working more on hugging in and keeping the hip square. Inhale, full exhale. Breathe in. On the exhale, open the hips. So now do your three-legged dog like you usually do, lifting the leg up, and then bend the knee, stack the hips. You can look under the right hand, the right armpit, coming into the fingertips of your right hand. Breathe in. Breathe out. So this is just to show you how you can have different ways of doing three-legged dog and different feelings. So here in this three-legged dog we're feeling a lot into the upper body, into the hip, maybe the quad muscles. And then the other three-legged dog we were doing, you feel a lot more in the back of the grounding leg. Inhale, come back into your three-legged dog. On the exhale, step forward into a low lunge. So pat up the knee, use a towel or double up the mat. I have a pillow here with me today. I want to show you how sometimes when I practice at home, which is not the case today, I actually have pillows to help me with my practice, which I like a lot more. Hands onto the front thigh. Inhale, lengthen through the chest. On the exhale, allow the hips to sink low. And give yourself some time here. You might not go low all the way down to start with. Breathing in, breathing out. So keep sinking the hips lower. And then press the back foot down onto the floor so that you have the back leg engaged. Inhale. Exhale, but notice now if you're sticking the bum up, curving into the lower back, then scoop the tailbone under, protecting into your lower back rather than crunching into the lower back. Sink a little bit lower if you have the space, if your body has melted into it. Keep your spine spacious and long. Shoulders relaxed, jaw relaxed as well. See if you can melt forward, down closer to the floor with your right bum cheek closer to the right heel a little bit more without compromising onto the lower back. So keep your Uddiyana lower belly muscles engaged. And slowly start to come up into a more straight crescent lunge. So your hip is in line with the back knee. And we're going to do like the cat cow, but in this standing position. So interlace the hands, press into the top of the front thigh, and then round up into the spine. What this is doing, from tucking the tailbone, rounding up mid-back, upper back, you start to feel a stretch into the front left thigh. Stay with it. Breathe in, breathe out. Keep tucking the tailbone under and reaching back with your mid back. Imagine you want to teach, you want to reach towards the back of the mat with your back. Fill up. Empty the air out. Now, the curve of the spine comes from your spine rather than the shoulders. So if the shoulders are up to the ears like this, then relax the shoulders down. Stay with the shoulders away from the ears. Inhale. Exhale, round up a little bit more. Breathe in, breathe out. Fill up. Exhale, slowly release. You can remove whatever you have under your knee to protect your knee and just lift the back leg, go straight into your pyramid pose. So you might need to adjust a little bit here, walking the back leg forward a bit more. So we want to have both heels on the floor and the front leg straight as well. But if that means your hands are away from the floor, then place things under your hands, or if you don't have anything to support, place your hands onto the thighs. Inhale, lengthen. Exhale, fold forward. Now hugging into the center. So the tendency is to just fall asleep here and do nothing, but actually the legs want to be engaged. So your right hip hugs back and your left hip hugs forward. Lift the front toes, engage into the front foot. And then release the neck completely and allow the weight of the upper body to just fold forward, bringing your chest closer to the front leg. If the back foot is coming off the floor, walk forward a little bit so that the back heel presses the floor away. And now start to come and bring your left hand onto a block, or you can leave it on the floor as well. I usually use a block for this one. And open into your revolving Trikonasana. So the right arm reaches up. Inhale, lengthen through the left rib cage. On the exhale, reaching up through the right arm. Breathing in, breathing out. And if you're losing balance here, you can adjust your feet, either shorten the stance or separate the feet a little bit more. Sometimes having the feet in different tracks works so you have more space for the twist. Deep inhale, reach up. Exhale, squeeze the thighs together. Same thing we were doing before. So hugging into the center. Good. Inhale. Full exhale out. Relax the neck completely. Inhale, reach up through the right hand. Exhale, twist with your upper body. Engage into the inner thighs. Breathe in. On the exhale, release the hand down to the floor. Place the block or books or whatever you have there to support you to the side and transition into your wide straddle. So turn towards the left side. Hands onto the floor. Inhale, halfway lift. On the exhale, fold forward. You're welcome to just rest the hands onto the floor, or if you need blocks and books under the hands, go for it. Lift the toes, and this will allow you to activate into your shin muscles, which then also activates into the calf muscles. The activation of the muscles around the leg protects the stretch in your hamstring. So many of us have tight hamstrings, and especially now if you're spending a lot of time staying at home, not really doing much, you probably feel a lot more your hamstrings being tight quite quick. Now slowly release, transition into Skandasana. So you're going to turn your left foot towards the back of the mat. Keep your right leg extended and just sit onto the bum. So we're going to do a slightly different Skandasana this time. Adjust yourself in the mat if you have to. Now the right hand grabs hold of the left ankle. So you have your right arm crossed in front of your pelvis and the left arm reaches up. Inhale, lengthen through the chest. On the exhale, bring your left hand behind the neck. And what we want is this counterforce to open the chest towards the ceiling. Breathe in. On the exhale, point your left knee towards the back of the mat. So you're opening into the left hip. Good. Inhale. Exhale, open the chest. Keep lengthening through the chest bone. Fill up. Empty the air out. Activate into the front leg. Right foot and right leg is active. Breathe in. Breathe out. Fill up. Empty the air out. Deep inhale. On the exhale, slowly release the left hand. Bring your upper body towards the center. And just transition into your half hero. So you're bending into the left knee. The left ankle is close to your bum. If this is too much, you can close a little bit here. Or if you're having any knee problems, you can just have a tree pose position. Now your hand is gonna clip. I'm gonna turn this way for you to see. Your hand is gonna clip onto the ankle and you allow the weight of the body. You're gonna lean towards the right, towards the opposite side. Allow the weight of the body to just take you towards the right side. And what we want to feel is a stretch all the way from behind the ear, down into the side of the neck, into the top of the shoulder, and even maybe into the elbow crease and into the forearm. So grab that ankle. And if you're doing a tree pose because you have any knee pain, you can place the hand under the bum. It works as well. So you sit on the top of the hand and you lean towards the right and you can feel the same stretch going all the way from the side of the neck down into the forearm. Anything related with shoulders and necks will be playing up a lot in these moments. We usually feel a lot of tension around those areas when we feel like we're carrying the world around us. You know, with so much planning or preparation that we have to do or that we don't have to do, or, you know, this is such a different times. We're not used to these routines, to this way of living that sometimes we're holding on to tension and pressure around this area that we don't even realize. Now release the left hand slowly and use your right hand to bring your head to the center. And the reason for that is because you just stretch the muscles on the side of the neck and you don't want to suddenly grip them to hold the head. So you want to use your hand to bring the head to the center rather than using those muscles you just stretched. Good, now transition into your half splits. So keep your left leg in the back with a pillow. Protect your knee and keep your hip in line with the knee. Frame your front leg, keep the front leg straight and tuck the toes. Inhale, lengthen. On the your body allows it. Could be you might need to be in the tips of the fingers. You might even need a block here under your hands. Whatever works for you. And whatever you're doing, hugging into the hips. So today we're doing a lot of this action of hugging in so that both legs are active. You draw the right hip back and the left hip forward, activating into both legs. Sometimes it is in these small little movements, in this kind of zooming in action in our body that we start to really find new ways of moving the body, or we start to feel a deeper connection to our body. Now leave the left hand down onto the floor and reach up with your right arm for a twist. Open the chest. Now inhale, lengthen through the left side. You might need to adjust your left hand further forward a little bit. On the exhale, open the chest, reach up through the right arm. Good. Breathe in, breathe out. Now squeeze thighs together. You might lose a little bit of balance here, so engage more into the legs. Inhale, full exhale out. Breathe in, breathe out. Fill up. On the exhale, slowly release. Come back into the center. Take the pillow or whatever you have under your knee to the side. Step back into your high plank. Knees down for tabletop position. Breathe in. Puppy pose. Chest down, elbows back. Inhale. Exhale. Inhale, cobra. Squeeze elbows in. Exhale, downward facing dog. Breathing in, breathing out. Left side, so feet together, left leg reaches up. And we're going to do the same three-legged dog we did before on the right side. Keeping the legs straight, not too high, so that we can square off your hips. And just play around with the squaring of the hips. The squaring of the hips is like hugging the thighs towards each other. As if you have something between your legs, you want to hug it in, you want to squeeze it in. And then you start to feel a stretch all the way from the ankle up into the calf muscle, maybe the back of the knee, maybe into the hamstring. And after the hug in, you're going to lift that left leg a little bit higher, but without opening the hips, keep hugging in into the hips. Keep the left foot active, flex the toes, reach out through the heel. Inhale, exhale. Inhale, reach up with the left leg. Now open the hips. Exhale, look under the left hand or the left armpit, open the chest. Different stretch here. We're opening into the rib cage, opening into the hips. Might feel it more into the inner thighs. And slowly come back into the center, step forward into your low lunge. So same thing, let's pat up that back knee, place the pillow or whatever you have there and sink low with your hips. Hands onto the front thigh. Breathe in, On the exhale, keep the back leg active. So press the back of the foot, the top of the foot down onto the floor. We're staying here for a few breaths. And in this class, I really wanted to do a slow dive. So when we practice at home and when we're practicing by ourselves, there is a lot more opportunity to tune in with our own breath, with our own body, and maybe find little areas in the body that feel tense or that we haven't been before. Usually practicing at home means you either discover lots of areas in the body to go into, or you just kind of give up a bit quicker because no one is looking. That happens, I know. But today we are here together and we are discovering areas in the body we haven't discovered before. All right, transition into your other crescent lunge where you have the right hip in line with the back knee. And we're going to curve the spine like we do in the cat-cow. Breathe in. On the exhale, press the thigh away, curve. And you want to feel the sensation in the front of the right thigh, all the way from the hip flexor down to the knee. Tuck the tailbone, curve all the way from the lower back, mid-back, upper back. But the shoulders are away from the ears, so the curving comes really from the spine. And now notice if your hips are a bit lateral, square them in. Same thing here, hugging, that hugging sensation or movement. Round up a little bit more, lift up back of the shoulders. Ooh, yeah, I can feel it in my thigh. I'm sure you do as well. And slowly release. Move the pillow to the side, pyramid pose. So walk the back foot a little bit further forward. I always have to do it so that the back heel is on the floor. Place whatever you need under the hands. Inhale, halfway lift. On the exhale, fold forward. And this is the thing when you're practicing at home as well. Most of the adjustments you have to kind of find them yourself, you know, the little adjustments in the body, because there's no teacher there putting the hands in your body and giving you an assist. And you have two options. You either do the pose just for the sake of doing it and you just do a pose, or you actually do the pose with an intention of feeling it. And when we are at home without someone assisting or adjusting the position of the feet, we have to feel more. So I hope you're already doing the hugging sensation that we've been doing. We've done it in the other side. We need to do it here again. And this will start to open more into your left leg. So you might feel it in the back of the knee or in the hamstring. Always breathing. The breath is our anchor. The breath is what helps us to move into deeper places in the pose. And keep your front foot active as well. Now release into your revolving trikonasana. Same thing. You know, most of us need a bit of a lift here. We need that support under the right hand. Now inhale, lengthen through the right side. Keep your shoulder in line with the wrist. So you might need to move the block further forward because you're going to lengthen the spine first. Breathe in. On the exhale, open and reach up through the left arm. Now notice your legs. If the back heel lifted, walk the back foot further forward a little bit. Inhale. On the exhale, hug in, square off your hips. Breathe in. Breathe out, letting go of the neck. Inhale, reach up through the upper hand. Exhale, hug the legs in. Keep your front toes lifted so that front leg is active. Breathe in. Breathe out. Now twist with your upper body rather than the arm. Inhale. Exhale, ground down through the back foot. Press through the outside edge like you do it in Warrior Two. Inhale. Exhale, slowly release. Move the block to one side. Transition into your wide straddle. I'm gonna turn to the other side. So here we go. Hands onto the floor. Inhale, halfway lift. Exhale, fold forward. So we're just using the weight of the upper body here to open the back of the legs and to lengthen the spine. That's why yoga is so prevalent in the world, because we do so many poses where we are lengthening the spine, where we are opening the space between vertebrae. It's why so many people, when they start doing yoga, after a while, they feel less back pain. We're constantly reverting the effects we create in the spine during our day-to-day activities of hunching forward or bad posture or just not bringing lengthening in the spine. Active feet, lift the toes, protect your hamstrings by activating the muscles in the rest of the legs. Lift yourself up and bend into the right leg. So we're going to go into Skandasana on the right side. You can sit onto the bum here and then grab your right ankle with your left hand. So your left arm is in front of you. Inhale, reach up with the right arm. On the exhale, lean towards the left foot. So keep your chest open. If you are closing in like this, it's a completely different pose. We want to open the chest. So we are opening into the lower back and into the side of the spine. Bring your right hand behind the head. Inhale, lengthen, press the head into the hand. On the exhale, open the chest. Breathing in, breathing out. This is quite a deep twist. You can almost get more of a twist here than you can do in chair pose. Chair pose, you're kind of stretching the side of the legs and the side of the body. Here, you're deep into the side of the body. I can feel it, I'm sure you can as well. Keep opening the chest towards the ceiling, and then that left arm can even press into the leg to allow you to open a bit more. Notice if you're bringing the right knee forward, keep opening the right knee towards the side, keeping your hips open. And slowly release, come back into the center. Go for your half hero pose, which is the ankle close to your bum, or if it is too much in your knee, just do a tree. Grab the ankle, so I'll show you how. Grab the ankle like this, so that you allow the weight of the body to lean towards the opposite direction. And your hand being clipped onto the ankle allows you to stretch the side of the body, the side of the neck. And sometimes in these poses, you need to find the little adjustment in the pose. So maybe you might need to lift the head towards the back a bit more to feel a deeper stretch in the side of the neck. Or maybe you need to bring the chin closer to the chest to feel that stretch. That's why sometimes it comes a point that you have to be your own teacher. We, the qualified teachers, can only guide you through poses, and then it's really more you finding those areas that are a bit juicy and you want to go there with your breath and you want to release the juice out of those areas. That's why I find that practicing at home, sometimes by yourself, really opens you to these little adjustments and to tune in to those areas where the juice is. You're going to release the right hand and you're going to help the head to come to the center using your opposite hand like we did in the beginning of the class. And we're going to go into our half splits. So keep your left leg forward and your right knee bent. Cut up the knee. Hands onto the floor. Inhale, lengthen or blocks if you need. Exhale, fold forward. And notice that you want to keep your right hip in line with the knee. Right, so we're not sitting back here onto the heel. We're not all the way forward here. We want to keep this alignment. And this is actually working us towards splits, to do the splits. So there's different ways to work towards splits. This is just one type of pose you can do to help you open into the hamstrings and into the calf muscle for splits. And then with everything, any deep stretch, you want to make sure that you're actively participating in the stretch. So flex those toes to activate into your calf muscle, which then also helps with the stretch in the hamstring. Bring the right hand down to the floor. Go for your twist. Inhale, reach up with your left arm. On the exhale, hug in, especially if you're losing balance. Inhale, lengthen through the right side, so you might need to adjust the right hand. On the exhale, open the chest, twist with your upper body that rather than your neck. Breathing in, breathing out. Now hug in, use that hugging sensation we've worked before. Square off your hips, breathe in, breathe out. Keep the front foot flexed, flex the toes, inhale. Exhale, breathe in, breathe out, fill up. On the exhale, slowly release. Transition to the front of your mat. Step back into your high plank. Knees down for tabletop position, breathe in. Exhale, puppy pose. Inhale, cobra, lift through the chest, squeeze elbows in. On the exhale, downward facing dog. Breathing in, breathing out. Feet together, right leg reaches up, inhale. Exhale, bend the knee, stack the hips. Deep inhale. On the exhale, half pigeon on the right hand side. As you know, I like to take my time to get into half pigeon, and I teach my students as well to take their time. And that's why I have the pillow here, because I wanted to show you that sometimes a block under the thigh is too much, but sometimes not having anything, it is not enough. So usually when I practice at home, or even if I'm in the studio, I place a towel under my bum, or I place a pillow, because there is sometimes that little space between my thigh, my hip, and the floor, which is a bit intense if I don't have anything under the hip, but a block sometimes is too tall. So explore with that. Maybe, use your pillows or use towels. You know, sometimes I even roll up the towel like this and I use the towel rolled up under my tie. So play with the things you have around in the house and see what works for you. And we're looking again for that juicy sensation, for that juicy spot. And sometimes could be in the front part of the hip, could be into the glutes. It could even be in the back leg. And then when you find that juicy spot, just stay there, breathe, send your breath into that area. I'm in that phase of my half pigeon where I want to add twists. I like to add twists because I get to those little juicy spots that are quite deep inside and I wouldn't get otherwise. So being at home in our safe space and with a bit more time, it's a great opportunity to explore these things. And the half pigeon has many different versions. It's not like only half pigeon can only be made in one set way. There's many versions of half pigeon. So it's not wrong if you stay in an upright position or if you go down to the forearms or if you open to the side or if you twist. They're all good postures, good poses, if you're getting something out of them. And now you can start to slowly take the back leg towards the back of the room. Bring movements into the hip, into the ankle. If you've been practicing all week, you probably feel it in your hips. I definitely feel it. I've been practicing every single day here with you guys, and my hips are really telling me, oh, you've been working us, huh? Now feet together, left leg reaches up, bend the knee, open the hips, breathe in. On the exhale, go to your half pigeon on the left side. Same thing, take your time, there's no rush. We stayed long enough in this pose for you to play around with it. And this left side, it's so much more tighter for me than the right side. It's great to have the pillow here, which gives me that support. And you know, when I actually started practicing yoga, I honestly, every time the teacher would tell us half pigeon, I would just go like, why? Why do we have to do a pose that it's so painful and it's so challenging? I used to have pins and needles in my feet all the time. And I even did a hip openers workshop, but I felt like crying, which is normal. I know. But for me, it was like, why do I want to cry? I couldn't understand, you know, my knowledge of yoga at the time was very, very limited. And you know, it took me a few years and to get really to understand half pigeon. It took me a few years, and that's why now I love teaching half pigeon and I do the hip openers workshop, and I really love how to share my, you know, my transition from not liking the pose, not understanding why we have to do poses that were so challenging and painful and give pins and needles and everything, to the now loving it to the point that there's so much discovery on it. But yeah, I did feel like crying in that hip openers workshop with my teacher. It was my teacher teaching the workshop. And it's because, you know, the half pigeon balances your Svadhisthana, the sacral chakra, which is around here, the belly button area. And that's where that's where our emotional house is. And that's why when usually we do a lot of hip opener poses or when we kind of work in this area, we release emotions a lot. And it's good because it just means that things are moving. The element of the Svadhisthana is water, and water makes things move. If the water doesn't move, it's like, you know, a little puddle or a little lake or something where the water is not moving, it gets rotten. It smells, it stinks. So here with us is the same thing. And very often we have emotions stuck in there and we need to get things moving. And hip openers do that a lot, a lot. Okay, let's transition into your down dog. Stepping back. Do whatever movements feel good in your leg. And now come and sit onto your mat. We're going to do Gomukhasa legs. So bring your right leg in front of you, the left leg behind, and knees in line with each other. You're going to sit between your feet, between your ankles. If this is too much in your legs, you can always sit onto a block or sit onto pillows. Do a little tower if you need with blocks and pillows. And then we're going to add our Gomukhasa arms as well. So grab your right arm, left hand from above, interlacing the hands. If they don't quite reach, then just grab a strap. Just feeling into it. Another hip opener pose. Allowing emotions to move. Allowing this part of the body that connects the lower part of the body with the upper part of the body to be decongested. Whether it is emotions or it is physical congestion, energetic congestion, we want to keep things cleared. And it's not just because we are in this situation in our lives where things are changing or where we are stuck at home or we don't know what's going to happen. Any time of our lives, we want to keep things flowing freely. So maybe this is just an opportunity for us to learn the importance of keeping our body on a free flow, keeping our emotions in check, understanding ourselves a bit more. I'm sure this whole situation that is happening is going to teach us a lot about ourselves, about human beings, about society. And now you can slowly release and extend both legs towards the front, give them a shake, and go to the other side. So I'd like to come into my knees and place one leg in front of the other, but you can do it from a sitting position if that works for you. And there we are. My left side is so much tighter than my right. Even in this pose, I can feel it. Ooh, there you go. And add your Gomukhasa arms. Breathe into it. You can slowly start to release the arms and extend both legs forward. Give them a little shake if you need, and lay on your back. Hug the knees, stretch out, do whatever feels good. We're going to do supine twist with eagle legs. Rub the right leg around the left and then take the legs towards the left side, right arm towards the corner. Breathing in, breathing out. And slowly come back into the center. Go on to the other side. So eagle legs on the left side. No need for double wrap if it is too much of an effort. Just do single wrap. This helps to deepen the weight into the left leg and deepen the opening in the leg, in your glutes. I can feel it in my armpit. And slowly come back into the center. Go into Shavasana. Final resting pose. Placing something under the head is good. I usually place a little towel or a block, but now, today, I have a pillow. I'm gonna place a pillow. That lifting of the head helps to relax more into the pose.
Om Satchidananda Parabrahma Purushottama Paramatma Shri
can slowly bring movement into your fingers and toes. Roll the head from side to side. Hug the knees into the chest. Roll over to the right hand side. Come into a seated position, eyes closed, hands into your heart center. Breathing in, breathing out. We're closing the practice with three arms. Inhale. Center. Together we say, Namaste.